Here's five things I think you need to know about Black Hat. Black Hat, from Dragon Dawn Productions, is a trick-taking game for 2 to 6 players. It's a hacking-themed game where you negotiate your way through various obstacles to get to the critical assets. However, getting to the goal isn't enough. As any good hacker knows, it's often about ghosting your way in and out without leaving a trace. This game is centered around trick-taking. So what's that even mean? Well, on your turn, you're going to be given a hand of 10 cards, and they'll number between 1 and 13. The aim of the game here is to win tricks, and you do this by playing the highest number card against your opponents. And that can come in single cards, double cards, or triple cards, and they will have to follow. Now, you also get additional cards like the Joker card, which acts as any number, and then the Black Hat card, which reverses the victory order, meaning that the lowest number cards will win. However, it'll force you to pick up cards, and you'll see why this is bad in a minute. When you win a trick, you get to move one of your hats, there are two you have, across the game board, working towards your end goal. And the board offers a whole bunch of challenges all of its own. Now, because you're a hacker, you want to go unnoticed, and this is represented by the fact that you need to keep as low a score as possible throughout the game. You score points from cards left in your hand after the trick-taking round, and also the number of the square that you have landed your top hats on add up too. So as you can see, the idea here is to win as many tricks while keeping your points as low as possible. Okay, similar games. To be honest, I've not really played a lot of trick-taking games, Custom Heroes being the only exception. But I do think that the addition of the board and the fact that your tricks are incredibly meaningful really make this game stand out. Setup is easy as there are a few components, and it takes about 30 minutes for two of us to play. Obviously, this lengthens when you add more players, but it also depends on the type of player you're playing with. The rulebook is perfectly adequate and answered any questions I had. Because this is a trick-taking game, you're playing against an opponent, meaning it'll be a little different every time, adding a lot to the replayability. But there are also additional boards which can add different rooms to the game board to give you plenty of options. Black Hat embraces colour, and I love how bright the game board is. The artwork on the cards is rather generic, but it's also incredibly fitting, and the component quality is very good. You gotta love those teeny tiny top hats. What's special about Black Hat? I think it has to be how accurate it is to its theme. So, in case you didn't know, a black hat is indeed a type of hacker. So, for instance, there's white hats who hack into places to kind of expose vulnerability and weaknesses for people. And then there are black hats who hack into places to kind of be extortionate and gain profit and get something out of it. Everything in this game is really connected intimately to the hacker world, and it's very, very true to life. Okay, so how do I really feel about Black Hat? Firstly, the negatives. And you might see this as a positive. This game thrives with more players. The issue I had is that at 2 players, the game ran rather long, and also the fact that we had some dominant strategies arise with just 2 players. And I think all of this is remedied by simply having more people. I think this game will thrive with more individuals participating in it. The positives. This is a really new approach to trick-taking games. The addition of the board that you have to traverse kind of forces you to think bigger than just each individual trick. There'll be times where you don't want to take a trick and times when you do, and you're going to need to plan your hand accordingly, really making it stand apart from similar games. Now, the addition of the Black Hat card is all kinds of genius, because on the one hand, it'll give you a benefit, but if you're stuck with it in your hand at the end of the round, it's worth 5 points, which is worth quite a lot. So you want to try and lump it off on one of your opponents, but determining when exactly to do that and hoping it stays that way is a really interesting and difficult puzzle. There is a 2-player variant when you play this. You play with a dummy player, and it's incredibly clever. Both you and your opponent take controls of this dummy player at various times, and setting it up so that you can have better tricks or so that you can put it in a worse position really adds an extra element of depth to the game that I wasn't really expecting from playing with a dummy player. It's actually really, really clever. Overall, this game is really easy to play and really fun to play, and it's very, very sharp. It definitely keeps you on your toes. Do I think you should have Black Hat in your collection? Well, if you're a fan of trick-taking games or games like Hearts, I think this is really right up your street. While I don't think this theme will appeal to everybody, that doesn't detract from the fact that this is an incredibly smart and well thought out game, and one I think that will surprise a lot of people. So if it sounds like you're anyway interested in anything I've said, you should definitely go and look it up and check it out. You've been watching Board Game Inquisition. If you've got any comments or queries you'd like to make about Black Hat, please leave them in the comments below. I'd really love to hear from you. If you'd like to do something nice, why not like or subscribe or tell a friend that I exist? That'd be marvelous. And until next time, I'll be here playing games, asking questions, and of course, perusing my collection. Take care.